nothing can harm you. My words will warm and calm you. Let me be your freedom. Let daylight dry your tears. I'm here with you, beside you, to guard you and to guide you. All I ask is every way. You, soon you'll see a golden stream of light.
Signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and the church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle that he wrought in Canaan of Galilee, and is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God. And to this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. If any man can show just cause, while they may not lawfully be joined together, let him now speak, or else hereafter forever hold his peace. Mark, wilt thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her, so long as you both shall live. Amy, wilt thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holy state of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him, so long as you both shall live. God instituted marriage and gives us advice from his precious word. He said, Paul says, the husband should love his wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. 1 Peter says to consider one another's needs, and Paul in Colossians says to have love and respect for each other. Paul describes love for us in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. He says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Let us pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this special day. Father, we thank you for this wonderful institution that you gave us. Father, we thank you for marriage. And Father, we thank you for this special young couple before us today. Father, we thank you for Mark and Amy. And we thank you for how you brought them together. Father, we know that you brought their past together. Now today, their past become one. And Father, they began this journey of life together with one another. And we thank you for love. And we thank you for the love we see for this couple, for one another. Father, as we see them, we see a couple that just seem matched for each other, Lord, and just seem so happy and so in love. And we thank you for that love that you've given us. Father, we thank you for how all their family and friends have been with them, brought up to this point. We thank you for all the support. We thank you for all the love. And Father, we thank you for your hand in this, in their family, and in this marriage. We pray your blessing upon them and pray that you'll just make their love grow stronger each day. Lord, again, we thank you for how you give us advice for your word. And I pray, Father, that Lord, this couple will always keep you a part of their marriage and in the center of their marriage. Father, again, thank you for all your many blessings. Thank you for this couple. And Father, thank you for each one here today on this special day. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Mark, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me. Okay. I'm Mark. Take thee, Amy, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forth, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us be part. Amy, I am. Take thee, Mark.
Take thee, Mark.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
can have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part. With this ring, I be with you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Bless, O Lord, this ring, that he who gives it and she who wears it may abide in our peace and continue in our favor and for their life's end through Jesus Christ, our Lord. With this ring, I be with. In the name of the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Ghost.
Bless,
O Lord, this ring that she who gives it, he who wears it, may abide in our peace and continue in our favor and to their life's end through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We're going to ask you as a congregation, if you will, we want to pray the Lord's Prayer together. We're going to ask you to bow your heads and let's pray this together. Okay. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Matthew chapter 19, the Bible says that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female, and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. For as much as Mark and Amy have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and his company, and thereto have given and pledged their love each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving rings, and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are a man and wife, in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, and you may kiss your bride. I now introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Mark Allen Stevens. being here, and you're welcome to reception at the Jonesborough Visitor Center, and you're dismissed at this time. Thank you.
Amen.